up in India, the sheer poverty and inequality that I had seen made me very interested in trying to understand what economics could do. And I think what I discovered during my PhD was that you could use the tools of economics to actually ask much more nuanced questions about power and politics. Why was it that some institutions would systematically exclude certain groups, and what it would take to give historically disadvantaged groups political and economic power? I'm Rohini Pande, Professor of Economics at Yale University and Director of the Economic Growth Center. Central to economics is this idea that there are trade-offs because we have a finite set of resources and we have to decide how to allocate them. Do we do it through markets and price mechanisms? Do we do it through redistribution through the government? In my own work, I'm very interested in thinking about policy as a tool of change. How can we look at patterns in the world to try to understand what policies will increase equality, what policies will lead to trade-offs between economic well-being and social justice? And I think that's the power of economics when it's well done, is actually being able to quantify those trade-offs. And repeatedly what we heard was this concern that if a woman, a young girl, had a phone, she would get a boyfriend. And it seemed that there was something linked between, very much based on the caste system, these notions of purity and controlling phone use of women. We go to the field and then really talk to them through a set of questions to understand their economic lives, their social lives, their preferences, their behavior. We typically end up serving both a woman and her husband, because one of the things that we're interested in is also looking at whether on the similar questions they may have very different responses. A woman might think that a mobile phone is appropriate for a woman to use, but her husband may not think it is, and that discord may be very informative of what actually happens. Certainly, I think a central part of economics is the toolkit, is the way of thinking about abstraction, of how do you go from just seeing everything that's happening in the world to distill it down to one force that you can focus on and say that was something that affected behavior. And I think that's something economics is very good at. But I think it's dangerous to take it to the next step of saying that as a result, we know something about what's going to make people wealthier or happier. I think to understand that, you have to have a much more nuanced view of politics or power. Economics can get to that. But I think that's where a little bit more humility and learning from other disciplines is valuable. Economics is also, I think, being pushed in the right direction by a lot of the social movements that we are seeing around issues of inclusion, of justice. Economists have to think hard about how do we actually think of notions of justice, not just efficiency.